And we're back with another episode of Mass Effect 3. This is the RPG chick. Gonna proceed with the main quest and meet with the council and all that kind of stuff. It's not really the... It's not a meeting with the council, right? We're done with the system, by the way. The chorus and skepsis, which is the Sigurd's cradle system. We have to go back here to the mass relay. The assets have been recovered. There's no fueling thing here, right? But we found fuel to keep us going. It's... meet with the diplomats. But I want to go back to... yeah, Apian Crest. 60%. Now... as far as I've been told, once you complete a quest, you can go back into the system and the Reapers are gone. So you can do your thing again. Trebia doesn't even say anything, does it? Let's see if we need any fuel. I love the new fuel sound. Okay, is 66%, Castellus 50%. Well, let's head to Castellus. Game has been saved. I don't know where we scanned before. Oh my, they're really alert. I found something. Hey! Am I safe while I do this? Or are we still counting down? Launching probe. We found a banner of the 1st Regiment. Cool. Oh, they're coming this way. 100% assets recovered. Yay! It's so scary. I don't know what happens when they get to me. Crap. I need fuel. I mean, I could have just gone in there anyway, but... good thing there is fuel. That completely unnerved me, that whole thing. With the Reapers coming. Two scans and they found me. Good thing I found something, though. I mean, I guess maybe you can elude them for a short amount of time and do one or two more scans, but they're quick. ...66% of assets. So maybe by the planet? Oh crap. Investigate the friggin' thing. Hurry up. 750 units of fuel. Cool. 100%. Done. So Trebi doesn't even have a thing there. Which means there's nothing there to find, I guess. Alright, cool. We're done! Yeah, I'm gonna try to get 100% of everything as much as we can. So, yeah, complete. Apian Crest. And Sigurd's Cradle. And where else did we go? Petra Nebula? Where's that? I didn't go over there. Hades. Kites. Exodus. I know I keep looking at this stuff, but... Petra? I guess there's no assets in Petra? There's only that one system. Alright, let's go to the Anos Basin to meet with the diplomats. Now, if I saw that correctly... This is not inhabited by Reapers, so we can just... We should be able to just scan away at our leisure, right? I'm guessing this is the only system. Let's check out, Peto. Peto, a carbonaceous asteroid, became notable for Element Zero deposits. The deposits, which indicate it was an extrasolar capture, were discovered by the Salarians shortly before they found the mass relay in the Pranash system. Naturally, all Element Zero was mined out long ago. The asteroid is named for the clan of Peto II, Ginon Mal Enest Dut Solum Amar, known to humans as Amar Solum. This shy, retiring eccentric was an undergraduate when more important astrogeologists passed off the first ESO deposits to him. He ran the fateful test and discovered its mass-affecting properties. For three centuries after his death, rival clans fought for credit of the discovery, but the truth won out after a lengthy academic war. Excuse me. Interesting. Any more asteroids? I'll just explore this asteroid belt. There's fuel. We don't need fuel. Yeah, too, though, when we find that fuel, we really save on money. Credits. Oh, I'm at the mass relay. I'm close enough to... Hate it, right? That's it for that, right? Halagus? Spacer investors are fond of saying you can't exhaust a gas giant, but the Salarians have certainly tried. Halagus, or whatever, is home to a thriving community of robo miners and those who work in Helium 3 collection and refinement. More than 16 of Halajuice's more metallic moons have been settled. The giant bears the name of the Halajuice Corporation, which combined the best efforts of several Salarian clans to manufacture the advanced shielding necessary to colonize the planet's moons. The planet's magnetosphere retains massive amounts of radioactive ions from Pranash, the system's star. Because of this, the cities on the moons are subsurface, protected from lethal radiation levels by shielding and thick layers of rock. Halajus was bought out centuries ago, but the name endures as a symbol of Salarian innovation and cooperation. Colony was founded in 560 BCE. Oh, really? BC? 560 BC. In Earth's terms. Population 129,000 capitalist AFA. It's gotta be on the moons because it's a gas giant. Check out that last Sur'Kesh. Named after a Salarian figure of some kind, I believe. The Salarian homeworld has been likened to the jungles of Earth. Pretty to look out, teeming with life, uncomfortable to live in, and dangerous to the unwary. The technophilic Salarians had significant pollution and waste problems early in the development of their society. They also embraced social solutions just as quickly, and through complex breeding rules, Sur'Kesh now maintains a crowded but sustainable population. The planet tends to be wetter than Earth, and Salarian cities spare no expense to collect and provide fresh water, as one might expect from an amphibious species. Due to Sur'Kesh's location in the galaxy, far from dark space, it has yet to be invaded by the Reapers. But its rulers are all too aware that they are in the path of attack, because they could not strike the first blow, as their military doctrine suggests. Many already consider their forces at a severe disadvantage. Population 10.3 billion. Population on orbital stations is 1.1 million. Surface gravity just below that of Earth. Atmospheric pressure just above. Days are a little shorter. Years are about the same. And finally, Saradrill. Oh, I saw another planet over there. Never mind. Gotta check out that one. Yeah, we might have seen it. I'm not sure. I'll take a look. Sur'Kesh's sister planet is in a weak hothouse state, retaining enough carbon dioxide and monoxide to form an atmosphere thicker than a garden world's, but thinner than a true hothouse like Venus. In the early days of Salarian space exploration, the species saw mining the planet as an engineering challenge. When the Salarians made contact with the Asari, the robo-mining industry developed for planets like Saradrill quickly became the galactic standard. The planet is named for the Saradrill clan, specifically the Salarian Dalatress, Saradrill II, Sorason Mal Netya Pator Nura, who sponsored the first manned mission to the planet. In antiquity, the planet was named for various gods, as well as the astronomer who first classified it as a planet rather than a star. But Nura's political machinations won out, and the planet now bears her clan's name on all standard Salarian star maps. Stuff. And what's this little guy? Dragle. Yeah, I didn't see that. What's this? Did I see this one? Sur'Kesh, yes. Oh no, I guess Sur'Kesh wasn't named after an important Salarian figure. I don't know. Might be remembering wrong. I remember seeing it in Mass Effect 2. Anyway, Dragle. The tiny rock planet Dragle is notable for its status as a strategic reserve of heavy metals. It has been warmed slightly by a thin atmosphere of nitrogen and carbon monoxide, but otherwise remains hostile to life. In the clandestine fashion typical of Salarians, a military outpost orbits the planet but does not appear on Alliance star maps. Like Saradrill, Dragle is named for the matrilineal clan that sent the first manned mission to the planet's surface. However, a thriving minority from the Silar clan, who sent the first manned mission to orbit the planet, insist to this day that their landing attempt was sabotaged by the Dragles and the planet should bear their name. Relations between the two clans remain tense. Alright. I guess we're done with all this. I checked out Helijuice Fuel Depot. We're full already. Diplomatic ships. Oh, should I scan for stuff? There's probably nothing in here. It's not saying percentage of anything. Sure, there's nothing in here. The diplomatic ships of the Salarians, Turians, and Krogan float far away from one another, out of weapon range. Messages sent by each faction indicate that they would welcome the Normandy as a neutral meeting ground for their diplomats. The fact that they have not agreed on a ship to serve as a neutral meeting point before now does not bode well for the negotiations. Agreed.
Commander, the Salarian Dalatras and Krogan clan chief are ready to come aboard.
Have them brought to the conference room.
This should be interesting.
This doesn't start another war.
The Krogan is in no position to make demands.
The Krogan has a name. Erdnot Rex.
Rex!
And I'm not just some junkyard Varen you unleash whenever you're in trouble. I've got my own problems. Reaper scouts have arrived on Tuchunka. So why should I care if a few Turians go extinct?
Trying to draw out negotiations will get you nowhere, Rex. I have no time for it. Just tell us what you want.
I'll tell you what I need. A cure for the genophage.
Yep.
Absolutely not. The genophage is non-negotiable.
I think they do deserve a cure. What's your concern?
Why are you so opposed to the idea, Dalatras?
Because my people uplifted the Krogan. We know them best.
You mean you used us to fight a war you couldn't win? It wasn't the Salarians, or the Asari, or even the Turians that stopped the Rachni. It was Krogan blood that turned the tide.
And after that, you ceased to be useful.
Oh, nice.
The genophage was the only way to keep your urges in check.
What?
Dalatras, you may not like him, but Rex
didn't.
Is right. Insulting him won't change that.
I won't apologize for speaking the truth. We uplifted the Krogan to do one thing. Wage war. It's all they know because it's all we wanted them to know.
You know, your people miscalculated with that.
Your people should have thought the matter through then. Was it really a surprise the Krogan revolted?
That's precisely my point, Commander. We made a rash decision. We turned to the Krogan in desperation. It's the same mistake you're about to make today. No good can come from curing the genophage.
But the Krogan deserve a cure.
The Krogan have paid for their mistakes. The genophage has gone on long enough.
1,476 years, if you're keeping track.
It was 1,000 years of peace, free from these brutes.
Oh my god.
Enough! Whether or not they deserve a cure is academic. It would take years to formulate one.
Maybe.
My information says otherwise.
Maybe not.
A Salarian scientist, Malin, grew a conscience.
Just thinking of him.
He was on my planet, testing a cure on our females.
Couldn't remember his name.
I remember. His methods were barbaric.
Mm-hmm.
But what you didn't know is that other females survived his experiments.
Oh.
So the Dalatras here sent in a team to clean up the whole mess and to take them prisoner.
Where did you get this? It could be a fabrication.
Don't insult me. Those are my people. They're immune to the genophage, and you're going to give them back.
She sounds nervous.
Dalatras, is this true?
How will curing the genophage benefit my people?
He asked you a question. You need allies.
How long do you think you'll last alone against the Reapers? Because if you don't help, that's how it'll end up.
And I'll be the last friendly Turian you ever see.
Nah.
What's it gonna be?
The females are being kept at one of our STG bases on Sur'Kesh. But I warn you, Commander, the consequences of this will be felt.
Will be nothing compared to what happens if the Reapers win.
Exactly.
Let's get the females.
You're not setting foot on Sur'Kesh. This will take time.
It happens now. As a Council Spectre, Shepard can oversee the exchange.
We're going.
Bye.
I won't forget this, Commander. A bully has few friends when he needs them most.
You would do well to follow your own advice there. Oh, I was hoping we could bring Rex. Or maybe Rex will be coming along anyway. Well, I had no idea this would be happening. I figured we'd just be talking to them. I'm gonna bring Garrus and Liara again. Only council members, you know. I feel like that might have a bearing. Confirm. I guess I don't have anyone to level up powers.
This is the Salarian homeworld we're headed to. They aren't used to seeing Krogan here, so let's keep it simple. We land, get the females, and leave before anyone changes their mind.
Well, he is coming.
I still don't trust a word they say.
Tempted. Be friendly, be nice. I know it's impossible.
Let diplomacy play out, Rex. You'll get what you want.
These females are the best. And probably last hope for my people.
We'll bring them back, Rex. Don't worry.
I appreciate that, Liara. I wouldn't want anyone else along for the ride.
I'm glad I brought her then. And Garrus.
I suppose I can make room for you too, Garrus.
Figured you'd gone soft, sitting on your throne. Forgot how to hold a gun.
Oh my.
I have a Salarian base on sensors.
Set her down.
Yeah, I mean, he might have had some options with the other two, but I can't help but think this was the right group to go along, especially for old time's sake.
Commander, Salarian ground control says we don't have clearance to land.
Tell them the Dalatras authorized this herself.
Yeah, land anyway.
I knew they'd never keep their word. Let's see them try to stop a Krogan airdrop.
Oh, he's just gonna drop. It's not that far, is it?
We have an unauthorized landing.
Nah.
And who authorized you to hold my race hostage?
Ooh! Nice. Did he have that power before?
Stand down! Hold your fire! Commander Shepard, restrain your colleague. We only found out about this transfer a few moments ago.
Alright, well, we can work this out.
I'd like to avoid a diplomatic incident.
As would we.
But you have something valuable to Rex.
Something worth dying for.
This matter can be resolved, but I must insist he remain under guard.
Or else?
And if we insist otherwise,
you'll have another war on your hands.
Seriously?
Anything goes wrong and all bets are off.
Ooh, he's pushing him around.
You've had it quick, and I appreciate your understanding, Commander. With war on everyone's minds, our people are on edge.
Oh, what the hell's that? Oh, it's one of those.
Careful! Watch the containment shield!
I remember those.
I'd hope to never see one of those again.
Yes.
As you can see, this base contains sensitive information.
From the lair of the Shadow Broker. Oh man. I know I'm gonna hear their name shortly, but yeah, they were basically we contacted them, or someone contacted them and decided to keep them confined to their own planet. And one of them became the Shadow Broker. Well, Shadow Broker decided to have a aide or pet or a combination of the two. And he killed the original Shadow Broker, whatever the hell that was, and became the Shadow Broker. And then we had to fight him. And that story, and Liara became the new Shadow Broker. So, what sensitive information?
What kind of work goes on here?
Evolutionary trials, morphological simulations, exogenetic assessments.
Nothing is ever simple with Salarians, is it?
Science has always been our best defense. The research we do here has kept Sur'Kesh safe for millennia.
Like studying Krogan?
Does that include studying lost Krogan?
The females were in poor health when we found them on Tachanka. They were brought here to stabilize their condition.
This whole planet smells wrong.
Yeah, no wonder they were in poor health.
I'd like to see them.
Of course. I'll need to clear you for the lower levels. Give me a few moments and meet me near the elevator.
Attention biolabs. Please prepare for Yogg specimen arrival.
The Yogg. Right. Oh my god, I freaking have a lead foot here. Two lead feet. so you know something's gonna happen. The Yogg's gonna get free.
Please don't touch that. As I said, Commander, don't touch that.
As I said, Commander, don't touch that.
Again, I would ask you to refrain from touching that.
Boop.
Perhaps don't touch that means something different in your language.
Yeah. We leave out the don't.
Boop. I would rather not refer this matter to the human embassy. Touch it all you want. You'll never find out what it does.
Oh, God.
Are humans really so deprived of stimulus that they must insist on touching everything?
Especially when I get such awesome responses, yes.
I'm afraid if you keep touching that, you risk a diplomatic incident.
I thought I'd never find out what it does.
Further manipulation of that object is grounds for further admonishment.
Really? You must stop touching that.
Yeah?
Once more, the Salarian Union formally requests that you not touch that.
Oh, the whole Union, huh?
Fine. If you are so enamored of that object, then I suggest you get your own feces analyzer.
A feces analyzer?
We've already been down that road. No more.
Oh, that's it. I want to touch it again. What about this one? I can't touch this one. I'm supposed to go that way. Okay, I'm gonna
agree with him or not. Our orders are clear.
Check everything out.
Smooth handover of the Krogan detainees.
Who gave the order?
Our superiors. That's all that matters.
But they're gonna cure the genophage. Everything we've done to stop the Krogan will be for nothing.
When I want your opinion, I'll promote you. Until then, stay sharp and keep your mouth shut.
Damn. Told you.
This is a restricted area. Please stay back.
Hey. But I like to touch things and go into restricted areas. I'll just hop over this. No? Okay.
This is Senior Research Director Wicks, authorizing visitor access to lower level.
I thought I could go in there.
Down and someone will...
Alert. Threat condition 2 has been declared. Scramble readiness teams.
Yep. I think I missed a part.
What's happening?
Sensors have picked up activity on the perimeter. Hurry, Commander. Someone will meet you below.
Hopefully I don't miss anything too cool, because I went in that door. I was trying to do everything besides meet with him. Until that was the only thing left.
All specimens are accounted for, sir. Shepard, excellent timing. Good to have you here.
Morden!
Morden?
Eyesight still sharp. Surprise understandable. Hadn't expected to return to work.
I recognized the voice first.
You're back with STG.
Special consultant. Had to be me. Someone else might have gotten it wrong.
Aw, I missed him.
Female Krogan fed information to Clan Erdnot. Encouraged political pressure to free females.
You must be Rex's inside source.
Yes, can explain later. Security warnings not normal. Need to get off world for sake of Krogan.
Okay.
Females had weakened immune systems. Side effect of Malin's cure. These didn't survive.
Yeah, I guess not. So Malin's data was useful, huh?
But what about Malin's research? I thought we saved it.
Indeed, data saved, but not complete. Lacks
partially useful
details to reconstruct cure, but still useful for synthesizing from living tissue. Couldn't save them.
You did your best.
I'm sure you did everything you could, Morton.
Arrived too late. Cannot delay now. One survivor, immune to genophage, can synthesize cure from her tissue.
Oh.
She's still here.
Yes, last hope for Krogan. If she dies, genophage cure... problematic. Please be careful. Krogan's slow to trust.
I'm Commander Shepard, Alliance Navy.
Are you here to kill me?
Goddess, what she's been through...
Erdnot, Rex, and I are here to take you home.
Why? What am I to you?
Is she permanently attached to that, whatever that is? Why are you so worried?
Have the Salarians been mistreating you?
Those are my sisters you saw back there. They died in a lot of pain.
Did the best we could.
And now I know I'm the only one left. That makes me dangerous to a lot of people. What about you, Commander Shepard? Why are you here?
To save the Krogan.
You're the future of the Krogan race. I'm fighting for that.
Then I hope you brought an army.
I brought a squad.
Give me an update.
Outbound communications have been severed. We're cut off.
Secure all data to off-site location.
What's happening?
Reapers?
We have multiple ships inbound.
I know the Yogg is gonna get free too.
Shepard, it's Rex. Cerberus troops are attacking the base.
Cerberus troops.
Get the females out there now.
Only one survived, Rex.
Female.
It might be safer down here.
What? So the Salarians can kill her like the others? No deal. If you still want this alliance, get her out of there.
Can she even be moved?
Release the female. We're leaving.
I can't. Protocol states during lockdown, no specimens.
Oh!
Objection noted. Now, please release Krogan.
Okay. For a second, I thought that was Morden who got electrified.
Need to monitor pod as it clears quarantine procedures.
Meet us at next checkpoint, Shepard. Likely Cerberus opposes genophage cure.
Reassure her.
You'll see T'Chanka again. I promise.
Get to elevator, Shepard.
All right, before I go up, let's see if there's anything we have found around here. Research log?
We've got to get moving, Shepard.
Autoimmune response. Krogan females dying. Malin's data details procedures. Spotted his error. Brute force application to alter hormone levels. Shows how far he'd fallen. Glad I saved data. Have developed counteragent. Saved at least one female.
Oh, there's fishies. So I guess we're underwater?
Put all research subjects into immediate lockdown. Watch us secure. What sort of problem? Fix it!
I know we got to fight the Yogg. Assault rifle extended barrel. One. So what's in here then? Can't get in there. We'll just have to wonder forever.
Log, Morden Solus, 162.3. Used STG ties to secure station here. Gained autonomy in caring for Krogan test subjects. Females were obviously dying. Barbaric experiments. Malin's fault. My responsibility to fix. Need to save them. No more. No more dead.
Morden's awesome.
Something's wrong with the elevator. It's not responding.
Well, that's not good.
Try it now, Commander.
Okay. Just hanging out, huh? Okay, save? I gotta save.
Try the elevator, Commander.
I'm trying it. What's that? Ah, oh, get away from the elevator.